So I pulled the trigger and I bought the new Google Pixel phone. And it's pretty dang expensive, but maybe worth it? I'm Ben from AuthenTech, let's dive in. Unboxing was enjoyable, simple and clean. I got the 5-inch display 128GB model. It's sporting the new USB Type-C plus adapters if needed. Design looks and feels ultra premium, and I mean, it's extremely comfortable to hold in hand. I'm coming from the 5.5-inch Galaxy S7 Edge, and I'm actually digging the smaller screen. It's nice being able to easily reach my thumb across to slide in panels or whatnot. I kind of missed this. It's rocking the hot new Android 7.1 Nougat, and I love the clean Android experience. It's actually one of my favorite things about this phone. It's super snappy and minimum. The new Google Assistant is a good friend. The buttons are nice and clicky, headphone jack on top, downward facing speakers. The chin at the bottom is kinda large and I wish they'd close that gap or maybe place some forward facing speakers. When will these companies learn that that is a huge feature that we want? The fingerprint scanner on the back is really nicely placed. I like this natural resting spot and the scanning was crazy fast, faster than my S7. Main internal specs include a Snapdragon 821, 4 GB of RAM, a 2770 battery that charges 7 hours in just 15 minutes. I found battery life to be great, lasting a full day of usage for myself most of the time. The 12.3 megapixel camera on the Pixel is all around amazing, and I actually made a whole video on that, so be sure to check that out afterwards if you haven't seen it yet. Autofocus is laser fast, 4K footage looks beautiful, HDR plus shots are popping off the screen. The auto uploading of full resolution photos and videos have been really nice, especially when I use my phone for shooting clips for my YouTube videos. One major bummer is it's not water resistant like the S7 or iPhone 7, and I'm hoping to see this in their next model. The other common issue people are having was this lens flaring. Supposedly there's a software fix coming, and I definitely had this in some of my shots. Sometimes it kind of looked nice, it was like it was shot with the DSLR, and I'm kind of about those lens flares sometimes, but if it's a mistake or too heavy or uncontrollable, that's not good either. The phone can be a tad slippery, so I went with the Spigen case on Amazon. It's pretty cheap, only $12.99. On a final note of price, this phone cost me $800 after taxes and all. That's a lot of money, and it really needs to be a top-of-the-line phone in every area to warrant that price tag, in my opinion. I'm personally split because my S7 Edge is a fantastic phone. It even has some features that the Pixel doesn't have, like the water resistance, and it's a lot cheaper device. But I'm really missing my 7.1 Nougat until that update comes over from Samsung, hopefully soon. In closing, I think these high-end expensive phones are going to slowly possibly fade away as the mid-range Motos and OnePlus phones are all around half the price and still packing in great hardware specs and features. If you're going to be buying the Pixel, I'm sure you will definitely love it, but if you want to save some money and go with something else, I won't blame you. Now thank you guys for watching, make sure you hit that thumbs up button and subscribe for more tech videos like this every week. Until next time,
let's live AuthenTech.